Hello and good morning from Proactive New York. Joining me today is Tom Thimot, CEO at authID. Tom, good to see you. How are you?
It's great to see you, Christine. Definitely feeling pretty good, having raised a large sum of money at a time that has been very difficult.
Yes, let's talk about that. You did close a funding round of $22.5 million. So tell us more about the fundraise and how you did, how you were able to raise this in the current economic climate.
AuthID is a company that's bringing to market very unique IP and, as a result, needs to forward invest. So we knew we needed to raise money. And at the end of the year, we didn't foresee that a combination of headwinds were going to develop. First the Fed starts talking about raising interest rates due to inflation. Then there's a broader sell-off of fintech and more speculative stocks. And then finally, Russia invades Ukraine, a very sad incident that obviously also impacted the market. So we were facing those headwinds, but we knew we still needed to raise the cash in order to be able to realize the vision that we put forth in the market. And this is where some very strong investors came to our aid. First Bill Brenneman and Verona Capital, which is one of my board members and been a longtime investor in the company, helped put together a convertible note that was joined by many other investors for $9.2 million at an interest rate below 10%. Then Steve Garchik, our largest shareholder, basically put together a standby credit facility that allows us to have another $10 million on top of that. Then a new investor came in at a market price where we sold them shares. And finally, the management team, we all believe in this. So we actually bought our shares at the conversion price, which is $3.70, which was more than 20% above market at the time we made the purchase. So super excited to get the money on the balance sheet. Allows us to realize this vision we put forth and ultimately fund ourselves through all of 22 and 23 and enter 24 cash flow positive, which ultimately is what every business needs to achieve. You gain profitability as you grow very rapidly.
So can you talk a bit more about how the funding affects authID from an operational perspective?
Because we're in an early stage, we're growing rapidly, marketing heavily, selling to new customers, new verticals. We need more cash today than we take in. So naturally, having cash on your balance sheet is really important when you're funding a loss for a period so you can gain traction. So in the simplest terms, we need the money in order to be able to grow. What was really an exciting point in the fundraise was where a number of our existing investors stepped up and basically said, yes, we're going to participate, and we're going to participate at these specific terms, which were better terms than a number of investors that we'd been soliciting were offering. And I think one key pivot point was where we met with Jamie Dinan of York Capital, a very well-known, very successful hedge fund manager that, was already a shareholder in the company and, basically through this more than doubled his position in the company and really gave us a lot of confidence that what we were offering, really was going to have traction. And, we also had Phil Brenneman, one of our directors, the head of Verona Capital, make a significant investment. And a number of others that signed up for $9.2 million for a convertible note at an interest rate below 10%, which once again interest rates are going up, so we were very pleased with that. And then finally, a private investor agreed to buy some stock at the market price, and a number of the management team members stepped in. And since the convertible debt instrument we had a conversion at $3.70, we at the management team actually bought at that price, which at the time was 67 cents above market, almost 20% above market. And so, that's how it came together. But I will say that, in addition to Jamie Dinan, probably the biggest thing was our largest shareholder, Steve Garchik, basically writing a standby credit facility for $10 million that really rounds out the 22 and a half and provides us all the capital we need to execute on our plan through 2022 and 2023 and enter 2024 cash flow positive. And, as an early company that's evangelizing and bringing something new to market, that's huge to be able to see a clear path to profitability and a clear path to cash flowing the right direction. And I think it was the combination of these things that, Fed interest rates and speculatives being hammered and a war in Europe, we were able to get past those and get the fundraising closed. Definitely was stressful and took up virtually all of my waking hours for about a month and a half.
Well, hopefully you can rest now. With that being said, what do you think the funding means for investors and the broader market?
Well, I think what the funding means for the investors and the broader market is authID now has the full chance to make its mark. And people are going, security is more important than ever. Every day you're reading about data breaches. There was just one of a major security vendor yesterday. Username and password and SMS messages sent to a cell phone are not secure. And in these times, whether it's fraudsters that are trying to steal money from you, or it's a foreign entity that is trying to negatively impact your business, you've got to secure who's getting access to your information. And, the beautiful thing of the message we were selling to investors was, this is pretty simple. I think everyone knows that a biometric of my face is a lot more secure than Tom123 with an exclamation point as a password, or a six-digit code being sent to my cell phone. Is it my cell phone? Has it been compromised? We know that a biometric is secure. So the market is coming straight for us. The forces that made it very, very hard to raise this money, the war, and all the cybersecurity threats that are coming as a result of that war, actually now are going to help fuel our business. Because if you draw a parallel to 9/11 and other times there's been major conflicts, the spending in cybersecurity goes up dramatically. And we are sitting with a solution that's been proven by customers to eliminate all forms of fraud, identity fraud, second party, first party fraud, and cyber attacks in general.
All right. Well, Tom, do you want to say congratulations again on closing this capital? Thanks so much for the time. Appreciate it.
Thank you very much for covering it. We're very excited about the future at authID.